Didn't that make you feel scared? Maybe because the bowstroke is fast, or maybe because of the sound of it? Tremolo, this is what we are going to learn today. And a lot of you are a little bit afraid to learn it, because let's be honest, it looks really, really quick, and it feels like maybe your hand cannot move that quickly. But in this video, you will hopefully see that it is not as hard as it looks like. It definitely is a lot easier than some other techniques that look a lot easier, like vibrato. And it is something that you can practice, and over time you can get better and better at it. And at some point, I'm sure that each one of you will learn how to do tremolo. So let's get started right away with learning tremolo. The first step is to make sure that your arm is relaxed. In case of tremolo, relaxation is really, really important, because on the moment that you tense up, and you can try it for yourself even without a violin, tense up your arm and then try to move your hand quickly, and you realize that it is a lot harder than if you would just relax your arm a little bit more. On the moment that you tense up your hand especially, it doesn't want to move anymore. So make sure that your arm and your hand is relaxed. The second step is to make sure that you are in the correct bow hold. So the correct bow hold looks like this. First of all, you have to make sure to put your thumb over here, and I have a full video on this and a blog post with very detailed pictures if you're interested. Anyway, we put our thumb a little bit rounded over here. This finger over here is hiding the thumb. Next finger next to it. This pinky finger is going to be on top, but it should be rounded. And the index finger is going a little bit further away or closer to the middle finger, depends what you prefer and what feels most comfortable to you. And then we have the correct bow hold. Now we are going to move the bow, not with our arm, but with your wrist and your fingers. And you can start doing this by doing it very slowly. This really requires some practice at first. And what can help is that if you have somebody around to help you, just ask if they would take your hand so that you cannot move it. Of course, you can also take your own hand if you wish to, but then you have to be very careful that you're not moving your arm anyway. What also helps is to put your hand against a wall. So for instance, if there would be the door, here would be the side of the door, and here you would have the door opening, and then you can like bow through the door, but you keep your hand against the door post so that it is easier to keep your hand in one spot. The fourth important factor in developing a good tremolo is that you have to play on the upper half of the bow. So playing tremolo over here is a lot harder than playing it on the upper half. And the stroke is also meant to be played on the upper half. So let's start practicing. Let's choose a note first. So for instance, you could choose the C. Place your bow on the upper half. Place your second finger ready. And now we are going to move very slowly. With our wrist and our hand. And now we are going to try to do that twice as fast. And each time you think you can double it, you can double it. Of course, it doesn't go that easy right away, but maybe for you it doesn't. Please let me know in the comments if you were able to do it right away. But you can slowly build it up, and each time you can try to do it again, slow motion, then go a little bit faster and a little bit faster, and try to go as fast as that feels comfortable for you at the moment. You might be wondering, so why should I learn tremolo aside of playing the horror theme? Well, first of all, there's a lot of nice pieces with tremolo, and I have a lot of examples of that on my blog. One of the most famous ones is Vivaldi, Four Seasons. It also sounds very nice if you play together with other violinists, for instance in string quartets or orchestra settings. And I put those examples of tremolo on my blog, so definitely have a look at that if you would like to see more examples. I hope that this video gave you a nice introduction to what tremolo is and how you can start practicing it. And if you're curious to what all the violin bowing techniques are, I created a nice cheat sheet and overview so that you can see all the bowing techniques that the violin has to offer. You can download it for free below this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you next week for my next tutorial. Bye bye, and please give me a like if you enjoyed it. Bye!